deck of cards clutched in his hand. He was the best damn cheat in the whole damn land. He practiced dealing both day and night, learned every move and every sleight. Seconds, centers, bottoms, greeks. Gambler's cops and gambler's peaks. Never had children, never had a wife, for the way of a cheat is a lonely life. Let's see, by the way, the cards are honest and I'm not, okay? And, yeah, they're all there. Don't you count cards that way?
Not that way.
Oh, I'll show you how to do it. It's very easy. All you do is just take and lay out the cards. Uh-huh. Use them one at a time, very quickly, count up 26. Count another 26, give it time, double check, 52, everybody knows that. And I'm going to tell you a true story. I know it's true because I make it up as I go along. Now, please remember from the top down, it's the 5, the 4, the 3, the 2, and the ace of spades. Mm-hmm. Dear, if I take the top card, what is it?
5 of spades.
Oh, you're paying attention. Now, if I take this 5 and I place it somewhere into the center of the deck like this, you know and I know that unless I cheat, there's no way that 5 can come back to the top, right? I'll tell you what, I'll do it again. Watch carefully. Okay. I take the 5 and I place it right into the center. Now watch my hands. Where did I place the 5?
In the middle.
In the middle. So there's absolutely no way it could possibly get back up here. You know, maybe it's a little bit difficult to understand with 5 cards. Mm. So we'll just use 4. Now, dear, if I take the 4, and I put it into the deck, you may think I'm cheating. So would you do me a favor and just push it right in flush? Thank you. Now, where did you place the 4?
Right in the center.
In the center. Mm-hmm. So there's absolutely no way it could get back up here. Maybe it's a little bit difficult to understand with 4 cards. So we'll just use 3. Now, sir. Now, Gary, if I take the top card, what is it?
That would be the 3.
3 of spades.
Correct.
So now watch very carefully. I'm going to take the 3 of spades and I'm going to place it face down between the ace and the 2, right?
Uh-huh.
It's now face down between the ace and the 2.
Right.
Yeah,
right. Face up. Face up.
No, face down. You see, if I place it face down, then when I turn the 2 this way and the ace that way, we know where the 3 is because it's reversed. You understand? No, dear. You see, if they're all facing the same way, it's hard to tell. Now, you don't understand. Look, if the 2's down, the 3's down. If the 2's down, the 8's down, 3 is down, I say, which one is the 3? You're going to be guessing. 3 faces the other way, then we... Difficult to understand with 3 cards.
Oh, no.
So I'll only use 2. Now, dear, if I take the ace and I deliberately place it on top of the 2, Corrine, where is the 2? Say on top.
Say on top. Okay, it's on top.
Now you're starting to understand. Now that leaves us with just 1 card. Now I'll be honest with you. I've been doing this trick for over 50 years. Well, not quite 50. 48. And I've never figured out what to do with 1 card. Particularly, of course, Gary, when that card is the ace of...
Ace of spades?
No, you see, that's the problem. It happens to be the jack of hearts. I repeat, this is not infallible. My success ratio is between 89 and 91% of the time. As I'm doing this, I'm going to explain everything that I am doing. Okay? So if at any time you care to challenge me, please feel free to do so. For the first time, would you look at your card? Show it around, let everybody hear, see it, I'll turn my back. Okay. Thank you. Robert, would you now take your card and place it anywhere you wish between other cards in the deck? Robert has now placed his card 22 cards from the top. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if at this point I'm only 1 card off, I'm going to miss this completely. Robert, would you please gather up all of the cards? Did you finish counting? Was that right?
Yeah.
Thank you. Well, no, I just wanted to make sure. You know, Now, Robert, in just a moment, I'm going to ask you to give the deck any 2 fair shuffles of your choice. Now, as you're shuffling, I will not be talking. The reason, I'm going to attempt to visually follow that card through 2 complete shuffles. Mm. Will you please give the deck any 2 shuffles on the table?
Okay. This
way? Any way down. 31.
Okay.
17. Robert's card should now be the 17th card from the bottom. Now, many, many years ago when I started doing this, you know, and at the particular Magic Castle, I always used to have somebody come up and blindfold me because that was very dramatic. However, when I went outside, people say to me, Martin, I don't know how you did it, but I have a feeling you could see through the blindfold. Mm. So in order that you and the rest of the audience can see that I cannot see, Robert, I have not touched the deck. Would you, Jean,
yeah.
Would you please pick up the deck? And if for a moment, if you just stand up with the cards and with their faces towards me, would you just drop them right into my pocket?
Drop, okay.
The whole deck.
Face just, towards you.
Mm-hmm. That way I know which way I'm counting. Okay, now can you see them in there?
I see them.
Okay, thank you. Now, my job is to find it. Whenever I used to do this, people used to come up to me and say, Martin, how did you do that? Now they come up to me and they say, Martin, why did you do that? I'm not dumb. I do it for the money. I was in Vegas not too long ago. I saw a friend of mine there. His name's Charlie. I'm sure you know somebody like him. You'd rather play cards. You'd rather gamble, you know, than eat, you know, type of mean. I said to him, I said, Charlie, I said, how come you win so much playing poker, you lose so much at the racetrack? He said, Martin, he said, I can't shuffle horses. You got to think about it. I did say 17, didn't I?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, don't lose it. Now, Robert, I think you'll admit there is no way I could have possibly seen into my pocket. I think you'll also admit that I have committed myself by throwing out one card. Robert, I don't know the card that you selected. I don't know what card this is, so I'm going to take a little look, okay? Robert, for the first time, what is the name of the card that you selected, please?
Eight of Diamonds.
Really?
Yeah.
As I say, I don't get this every time. But ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the times I got it. Me, if you would, sir, cutting off a small packet of cards and placing it face down right here. Thank you. Now, Robert, if this were a marked deck, which it is not, but if it were, the back designs would be changed, altered, and coded in such a manner I could immediately tell you what this card is. For exactly the same reason I could tell you what this card is. But if you really stop and think about it, there is no way anybody could know that bottom card, the cutoff card, simply because it's neither a face nor a back to see, right? Now, every card in the deck has in it what we refer to as a twin. As an example, the twin of the Seven of Hearts would be the Seven of Diamonds. In other words, it's a card that would have the same color and value. Conversely, the twin of the Seven of Spades would be the Seven of Clubs. You get the idea?
I got the idea.
I thought that you might. Thank you. Now, Robert, if you'll remember, a little while ago, you've shuffled this deck on several occasions.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Uh-huh.
We now have 26 packets of cards consisting of 52 cards. Two cards is a packet. Now, because of the physical nature of a deck of cards, the odds of there any being one pair together of the same color and value, of course, is one chance in 26. Robert, if such a packet, and I don't know if it does or not, if such a packet does exist, and I ask you, not me, but you to try and find it, you're only going to have one chance in 26 of finding it. So the true odds of you finding any pair from a deck that you have shuffled is exactly one chance in 676. In other words, it's a worse bet than Keno. Oh. Robert, would you look at the cards, and if you think there might be a pair, and I don't know if there is or not, if you think there might be a pair together, would you please tell me what you think it might be?
No, it's right there.
The Queen of Hearts.
Mm-hmm.
Now, would you care to change your mind?
Mm-mm.
Please.
Did you change my mind?
Mm.
Okay.
No, it's okay.
Oh,
right.
Look at that.
Robert, the odds of you finding two pair are one chance in 47,296. Now, do you want to take a second try, or do you want to see what I have hidden behind the curtain?
I'll try it.
Okay, would you take a look and tell me which one? The Ace of Spades.
I like this.
Robert,
yes.
The odds of you finding three from a deck that you yourself have shuffled are well over one in a million. Jack of Clubs.
Jack of Clubs.
Whoa.
Thank you.
Oh.
Oh, look at this. Oh. You're kidding.
Oh.
By the way, we're having a little game at my house. I accept both Visa and MasterCard. Thank you very much.
Oh,
thank you.